everyone. My name is Sarah Klaus-Nolles. I am the senior class president. And me, myself, the class officers, and the rest of the boys here, we have 8 of them, have been working really, really hard on this show, so we hope you enjoy. We also have 4 judges in the back. We have Senora Soto, Senorita Reardon, Mrs. Kinkilla, and Mrs. I. And they're going to help us decide who is the next Mr. Nipmuc. And as well as them, you guys are going to cast your votes at the end of the show to see who you think should be the next Mr. Nipmuc. So to start off, we're going to watch a few videos that the contestants have made so you can get a little bit to know them and see who you like. All right, enjoy.
Check me out on Instagram at MarcoGuid123. What Mr. Nimmark means to me? means I can pursue my dream in becoming a professional Mexican wrestler. Just as long as Zach Hunter does not win, Mr. Nimmark.
Hey, Zach.
Oh, hey.
So, you know, if you win Mr. Nimmark, you get rights to the treasure, right?
Oh, what treasure?
You know, the treasure of I'm a Wiener.
I'm a Wiener?
Yeah. hanging off the wreck and just off.
Oh, hey. My name's Randall Fabe, and I'm trying to be your next Mr. Nimmo. Why do you deserve to win Mr. Nimmo? Well, I think I deserve to win Mr. Nimmo because I can help my mom pay for the medical bills that Cam has caused for punching me. And Jake got to play basketball. Thanks, guys. Not only do I deserve you, I need you, Mr. Nimmo. Maybe I'll get out of here. Or maybe I'll be joined by my 2015 homecoming friend someday.
Six or seven out of ten, maybe. someone's gonna know my name, okay?
Good evening, everybody. Thank you for coming. Thank you to all the school officers and Sarah Blasnalis for letting us host this event for you guys to enjoy tonight. Let me start by introducing myself. My name is Joshua Davis. I'm a senior here at NIPMUC. Today I'm going to be your funny, handsome, manly, black show host tonight. Kind of like Steve Harvey, but I won't mess up the names like he did when he hosted Miss Universe. All right. Let me introduce you guys to some of the contestants you just saw in real life. First up, the punniest kid in school. Mind you, he's the only one who calls himself that. Mario Ciccone, come on. Just want you guys to know that anyone who disrespects the host, you don't vote for that person. Next up, may I please direct your attention to the back left corner of the auditorium. We have Marco Ciccone. As always, a grand entrance for a big man. Thank you, Mark. Next up, this is the kid your mother never wanted you to play with at school. Max Hubbard, can you please come up to the stage? Max. Max, where you at? Max, where you at, man? Come on. Max.
Max. What? Oh, there he is.
Don't get out of here. Yeah, come on. Mom always wanted you to invite over after school. Zach Hunter. If anybody took a photo of that, I wanted to be deleted immediately. And not see it on any social media. Anyway. Next up. Is Brandon LeFave, otherwise known as Butter Tees, Twinkle Toes, and all the above.
Yeah.
question? The boy who never got any Christmas presents. Brett Siegel. Questions for them to answer. hands. Here we go.
All right.
Is that all you have to say?
A couple more things now that I have the floor.
Let's see, we bought him a car, we paid for the insurance, but he can't seem to get up to bring his sister to school.
Shame.
We love him, but he does. He has a lot of good things about him, but here's the other thing about the bathroom. So the girls have to use my bathroom because they can't even open the door to the kids' bathroom because red stuff is everywhere. Whoever said girls were messy have not met unless I'm rich!
Well, do that. And then I'd say, hey girl, are your parents bakers? Because you got nice buns.
But why the banana?
It's for the effect. It's what reels them in.
All right, this next question is for Marco.
How you doing?
I'm good.
Good.
All right, Marco, your question is, who is your favorite teacher and why?
Oh, that's easy. It's the one teacher that puts up with my inability to read or write. That's Mrs. Ide. And I need help with the crowd for one thing real quick and help all these guys. I need you all to chant Mrs. Ide if you want to be ready. One, two, three.
Mrs. Ide! Mrs. Ide! Mrs. Ide! Mrs. Ide! Mrs. Ide! Mrs. Ide!
This next question is for Zach Hunter.
Yeah, Zachy.
What's up, baby? Oh, don't call me that. Alright, Zach.
You're cool. Come over here. What are you
doing? What contestant do you not? Can you say? What contestant do you not want to win the talent show, and why?
All right, well, I really don't want Brett to win. Well, because he's a penny pincher who only spends his money on fishing, even though I'm a better fisher.
Is there anything else you have to say for Brett?
Brett's ex, she left him for me. Actually, both of them.
Questions for Andre.
thinking Zach Hunter. Just look at him, you know, he's tall, he's lanky, that just spells sinister right there. With that evil smile he's got, you know, somebody's about to die, he's already dead.
Coat and a hat on a rack. Hat, Co says to the hat, I'll hang out here, you go on ahead. There was a butcher that backed up into his meat grinder, got a little behind in his work. Anyone know how to throw a party in space? You plan it. Anyone know any deaf jokes? Because I haven't heard a good one. I got some shoes from the drug dealer. I don't know what he laced them with because I was tripping all day. According to all known laws of aviation, no. That's something else. There was an Italian chef that died. He passed away. That was just the pizza history. You can only do so much. There's a tape factory that is going out of business. It's a real sticky situation. Right across the street from there, there's an ice cream shop that closed. The owner had a meltdown. There's some news. There's a prejudice that was murdered. Details are sketchy. I dropped this thing right here, but I don't want to hurt my friend Mike. Thank you very much.
just saw the come back here and check out the Peace, Love, Positivity concert, April 28th, 2017. And with that, I have one question for you. Ladies and gentlemen, when Brian Bernard and Marco Chinozzi, Wonderful Happenings, come back, will you come back?
Next talent is performed by Maxwell Brothers. It's called Dance Club.
I love you, Marcus.
Hello. I don't have much to say, but I think it would be good to have some Holy Santos brought to the high school. Guard the hallway if you bring us good luck. El Santo Niño de Atocha is a good one. My Atocha has seen you. And we have a great FFA schedule lined up. And I'd like to see more of that. If you vote for me, all of your wildest dreams will come true. Thank you.
Spotlight down here. Ben, do you want to come up on stage with me?
come back. I'm gonna give you the mic. Talk to the audience for a second.
Because you look so pretty!
Thank you.
Yeah. Show up to Nick Clark. Hey, Derek.
Yes.
Hello, hello. Show me the stand.
Okay, this is the, what have I gotten myself into, okay? This is a little too real.
So I go up to him, I'm like, hey, can you kill this man for me? He's like, how many men did? Two? Is two okay? $75. $75. You will never find a murderer for that sheep, let me tell you. I've tried before. $100 at the very lowest. $75. Come on. So I'm like, you're my guy right there. Shake his hand. Don't shake his hand too long, you know. Russians, they don't like sort of like touch, you know. That's all I got for dead people. I have a checklist here. I wrote it on a napkin. I can't read that. Oh yeah, my handwriting, it resembles like what the Sumerians used to know how much bread they had. This is a true fact, by the way. Back when I was a wee boy, like, they would pull me out of class just so I could practice. This is not a joke, by the way. They would pull me out of class just so I could practice my handwriting. 4 years of that, by the way. It's done nothing. Can you have a water, please? Thank you. Wait one second. I remember you. For those of you who are like half asleep like me, back when we had this thing called FAST, we had a challenge of a duel of death, really, between the grades, where we had to flip water bottles. So I was chosen by a certain Kyle. You may know him as the guy who didn't want him as the president, Kyle Bernero.
Hey, what did you say to me?
I said you're not the president. You don't deserve it. Get him a mic, Josh.
Would you like some Chinese food? Andre.
Yeah.
How old are you?
I am 7 years old.
I have been raising you for the past 7 years. Do you realize how hurtful your words may be?
Maybe you weren't a good dad.
Look at this shirt. I made it special.
This is my face.
Look at this picture. Do you know what this is? Look at this picture.
That's me.
What? It was you when you were 1 year old.
I didn't know. Sorry.
I taught you better than this one, right?
I mean,
to expose me live on stage. Why would you do such a thing? No. You can earn it when you respect me.
I'm so sorry. What can I do for you? Anything, I'll do anything. Not that anything.
Well, maybe if I don't finish this Chinese food, I can take the rest. But I need to finish it first. That means you cannot have my Chinese food.
I see how it is. See you in divorce court, Kyle.
Is Mrs. Ide there?
Mrs. Ide!
I'm gonna shout out to Mrs. Ide. Thank you for letting me pass your physics class, Mrs. Ide. Also,
give it up to the worst president of all time. So yeah, 1,000 years of pain because of this. 1,000 years of struggle and pain. I've contemplated so many things, so many tearful things, right? Because I can't do this. But every single time I try, it's not landing right. And it's not my fault, okay? You know how I took therapy to write better? This is also real, by the way. Around that same time, they were also pulling me out of class to get my muscles into what they could consider decent for a human being. This is also not a joke, by the way. So, here, Kyle nominated me to do that. And you guys all expected a man who can't even write his own name to be able to flip three bottles in a timely manner. What do y'all have to say for yourselves?
Don't regret anything.
Take that back. I'm gonna try this again, okay? Hold on. I don't even know what's a real cough and what's a fake cough anymore. Ooh, that one's close. I'm gonna try that again. Getting better, getting better. Okay, that one, I'll admit that one wasn't that good. Me, guys. We're gonna try her again. Shh. baby's first steps right there. All right, I'm done, I'm bored.
I've been ordered to stall.
Yeah.
I don't know how to do that.
Tell us a story.
Tell us about yourself.
I already did at the beginning of the show.
What's your middle name?
I'm not revealing that. Safety reasons.
What's your favorite sport? Well,
I don't play sports, actually.
Why not?
I don't know. Worked out, that's what I do.
What's your bench?
Max bench is 215.
Okay.
What?
Okay.
Alright, Brandon, are you done? Ask me questions, I'll answer. What? Okay, so apparently we're good. Alright, that's all we have for talent. Next up is the evening wear segment of the show. This is the last time you see our contestants. They're going to be coming out in their cleanest, sexiest outfits. First off, we have Mario Ciccone.
Thank you.
Everybody make some noise if you had some fun tonight. Sorry, my hearing's going bad. Make some noise if you had some fun tonight. So, I've had such an awesome time here at Nimuck all throughout my 4 years, and now I get to finish it off on this stage performing in front of the greatest people. Because you guys have been one of the greatest crowds. You laugh, you cry, you just perform. You guys did the whole entire sea full of stars with all the flashlights. That was incredible. And it's Mr. Nimuck tradition to have a proposal. Which is precisely why I'm here.
Okay.
So there's no other way to say this other than and a very special question for your special girl.
Oh, yeah. Yep.
Meg Lacey, you want to go to prom with me?
Thank you.
Josh is going to announce it in just a second, but just to explain how the voting worked, we had you guys all vote, and we got the results of that, and then we got the results of the judges, and then we split that 50-50. So it's a 50-50 shot between, we took 50% what you guys said, 50% what they said, we averaged it out. So that's how the voting worked, and now for the results.
Thank you, Sarah. Now, based on what she said, Brett Siegel is the winner of the Mr. Jim Buck Talent Show 2017.
Thank you, Mom. I know you didn't want to do that, but I'm just really happy I won because I finally beat Zach in something in life. And these guys were great. It was a lot of fun. And thanks for voting.
Thank you all for coming. Hope you enjoyed tonight. Have a good night.
Hey, Josh.
Hi, Josh.